تجد me again, I dig out of Kodada, I am a lecturer for parallel and distributed systems. In our second meeting, we are still discussing about distributed system model. This is our fourth video. We are going to discuss about communication paradigm. Okay, so this is our three about architectural model. There are so many to discuss. Some of them we have discussed in our last video. This will be discussed in the next video, not now. We have discussed about communication entities, we have discussed about roles a little, and we have discussed about placements a little. Now we are going to go deep in this one, which is communication paradigm. There are three types of communication paradigm that we will discuss. The first paradigm is the most basic paradigm in communication. What do you do in communication? There are two entities, minimum two entities in a communication. The communication will take two parties, and one will need to communicate to the other. If this is the most basic communication, then the roles are, the first one is to send, and the second one is to receive. This is the most basic. So the first paradigm is the most basic paradigm of communication. This is called inter-process communication. Discuss more about inter-process communication. The example is called socket. Now, the second paradigm is something more complex. Usually, a communication will not only go one direction but two directions. So when someone sends a communication to another, someone usually answers. So there is a if someone answers, then it means that the couple for answer is question. So someone usually asks, and someone usually answers. So it's two, usually two directions. This is the second paradigm. So, the asker is usually called the client, and the answerer is usually called the server. So, the server always serves the client. The client asks, and when the client asks, the server will answer. This is second paradigm. The second paradigm is called inter-process communication. No, sorry, that's the one before. This is called remote invocation. Three types of remote invocation: request reply, RPC, and RMI. The first paradigm comes with one problem from the second paradigm, which is, what if the answer comes before the question? Now it becomes more complex, because the question does not want answers before before it asks. So we need a third party. The third party is called a broker. And then this is the first one, this is the second one. Now the client is called the publisher, the subscriber. The difference between subscribe and ask is you subscribe for answers. Tell me when there is an answer, and then now the server is called the publisher. The publisher can go before the subscriber goes. So if there is an answer when it subscribes to the broker, it will directly get an answer. That is the first paradigm. So there are three paradigms. And in direct communication, there are many examples. The first example is called publisher subscriber, and the second one is called FHQ, but there are some many more. These are some little examples. So there are three types of communication paradigms. There is inter-process communication, there is remote invocation, and there is indirect communication. And that's the end of video. In this video we have discussed about there are three paradigms of communication, and the next video we will discuss about patterns. Thank you for your attention.